Hello, guys, gals, and non-binary pals. Welcome back to my channel, and today I wanted to go over how you can make money with each specific crafter. And this video is starting with leather worker. Every single crafter is profitable in their own way, but of course, I will follow some basic principles that I look for whenever I'm looking to make money. So I will also include a team craft list, well, a few of them, that will include some items to look out for, and all of these things will be linked in the description below. So with that being said, let's get into it. So of course, every crafter has its own purpose, and every crafter has its own strength. The best thing in Final Fantasy though, is that every crafter needs all the other crafter classes for each of their craft. So even if you're a weaver and you're making a dress, well, that dress might need something from a leather worker or an alchemist. So there is not one crafter that's way better than all the rest. This kind of mentality helps keep things in the game profitable purely by it being crafted. And we can see that in motion with leathers. So first is leathers. I will include a team craft list of all the leathers in the game that you can craft and sell from level 1 to 80. The leathers that I find that are most noteworthy, and starting with the crafters who are little bit low level, you should start with Algoat Leather, Boar Leather, and Uraeus Leathers. If you're over the level of 50, Tiger and Dalmel Leathers are also very good. And if you're max level, then Megalania, Thylacoleo, Zoner, and Sea Swallow Leathers are very profitable. If you're looking to buy every mat and just craft, then of course, Server Hop, find the cheapest mats across your data center. So next is Glamour. So you don't have to do treasure maps yourself if you want to make a profit. Of course, if you plan to buy the leathers yourself, then Server Hop for the cheapest prices across your data center to make sure your range of profit is the highest. Also, avoid glamours that come from outside resources, such as Bolstra or the lockboxes from Heaven on High and Palace of the Dead. My most notable glamours are the Gryphno Skin Breast Guard and the Uraeus Coat for those who are a little low level. The High House Boots and High House Half Boots are also good if you're not completely max level. And for those that are max level, the Hooded Fire Glass Vest, the Calf Skin Set, and the Urban and Rebel Boots. Third is housing items. Now, housing items are very, very server dependent. If you're on a server that has a lot of people just barely ever finding a house, it's always the same people with the same house, you probably will have a lot less buyout of housing items. Although, just check the price history of each of these items, see how often they are bought out, and for, of course, how much. If you're on a server like me, where housing comes and goes with a lot of different people, housing items are still pretty profitable. And of course, with the new Ishgardian housing coming soon, this will be relevant for everyone later on. So with that being said, the most notable furnishing items for a leather worker is the leather sofa and the step bed. Next is green gear. I've made a lot of gil just making old world green gears, and what I mean by green gears is just old content end game gear. So Naoish Guardian sets, facet sets, etc. And people use them now for glamour. So the best one is by far the Naoish Guardian tops, aiming, casting, scouting, and healing, and also the Dreadworm tops, the replica Dreadworm tops are also very good. Fifth, of course, is crafting and gathering leveling gear. You do not have to be max level to start this. Any of the crafting and gathering leveling gear is always profitable if sold at HQ. How I make a large profit is I just buy out until a certain amount. So let's say there's 8 postings of 1k per HQ of this item. I just buy them all out and post the item and my items for around 50k. And I make sure that whenever someone undercuts me by a whole lot, I just buy them out, keep my item at its original price, or if it's too consistent, I move my items to different servers. But since a lot of people are leveling their crafters and gatherers, this is extremely profitable and will be even more profitable when Endwalker releases. And six is the leather worker quest items. Since, of course, as I said earlier, a lot of people are leveling their crafters, and a lot of them are just too lazy to do their quests until it's too late. And Well, to unlock certain skills, you have to do the class quest. So they end up buying the items that they need all at once from the market board, which is something that I did. And you can profit off of this by crafting those quest items that are needed. And the best quest items that I've sold so far is the Chivalric Long Coat of Aiming, of course HQ, the Dragon Skin Choker, and the Dalmel Skin Leggings of Scouting. So that's every way that I personally make money with my leather worker. Of course, check the lists that I include in the description below and check how it is for your server. And if you have anything to add or maybe something that not everyone might know, please feel free to comment. I will also be making one for every crafter, so stay tuned. And of course, join my Discord if you haven't already. I have a whole load of resources there, so if you're interested, it'll also be in the description below. So thank you for watching, like, comment, and subscribe if you want to. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye-bye!